DC here. Hi guys and gals. Well, hope you're well. Today is Sunday and it's, I was gonna say, yucky weather. If you can see right here, like, it, this morning we had a dusting of snow and now it's warmed off up a little bit, so it's kind of melting, so it's slushy, and it's probably vlogger's itch. It's probably going to cool off before long, so all that slushy niceness is going to become a little ice field, I guess. Yeah, yuck. I was walking to work this week and my feet slipped and I fell down. Hurt myself a little bit. I mean, you know, nothing serious, but I did feel it. Didn't feel it at the time, and then I felt it in the shoulder a little bit after, but you know, just a bit. And it's okay, but I've got those, maybe you know these, it's like a shoe, it's like a thingy, almost, I was going to say almost like chains or something, you know, studs that you can put on your shoes. So I put some of those on, and I might put them on tomorrow actually, because depending on how it is, you know, it was black ice as we call it, and you know, I didn't see it. Yeah, so it's kind of like in between snow and rain right now, so I'm not really happy with that. Oh, so what we chat about today, talking about falling and everything, and with the weather, and yeah, I saw a paper, it was a little article, let's see, I'll pull it out, here you are, it was in Nature, okay, it was in the January 8th, issue. Oh no, it was not Nature, it was in Science magazine, sorry. Like, they're the two big ones. Nature is the British one and Science is the American one, basically. But the article was on how mice feel each other's pain or fear. And they're basically saying there was different neuronal pathways that mediated empathy or, you know, different states, so fear and so on. And they made like these little tests where if there was like a foot chalk or something like that, and you saw it, it's kind of like looking at torture, you know, and you saw it, or something happens to you, well, you become like more sensitive, even in your own pain, if it happens to you, at least with the mice. And that's considered a bit like, you know, mediating empathy or fear, because depending on if you see something's going to happen to the other one, something lights up, you know. Basically, it's, they're showing that, you know, we've got circuits in our brain that, you know, make us show, or at least mice show also empathy to pain and fear. Now, I don't know if it's empathy that they're feeling or if it's just the fear of having something or the same thing happen to themselves. You know, it could be that, and that makes, you know, hypersensitive. Now, you know, without going into a scientific discussion, it is interesting, but what we all know is that you can be desensitized to seeing somebody else's. So I guess I'm going to stay under here. It's not raining on the camera. You can become desensitized to, you know, seeing somebody's pain. I mean, it's all been, you know, we've seen it in movies, we know it happens, we've seen it, you know, people tell stories, horror stories from war and something, and how people know, you know, they just see it and, oh, okay, or it's not me, it's somebody else, and you just see it so often. And I think that that's a little bit what's happening with a lot of people lately on social media. You know, we've talked about, you know, disinhibition and how nice, and I put it in inverted commas, nice people become horror, I was going to say horrific people in their comments and stuff, and you listen to them and you say, funny, they didn't seem like that before. And yeah, you know, it just, it's one of the things that people were talking about a lot lately, people are talking about, you know, is the effect of social media on people's characters. And I guess that, you know, without a doubt, we can say that, you know, people show a lot of disinhibition in social media. It's funny because, well, it's not funny, but I mean, it's strange Because when we all, a lot of us all start, like for example, YouTube, which is considered as social media, but in a different way, because you know, you're putting yourself in front of a camera. You've got that facial expression, and if actually you're going to say hateful things, you're going to say them. You're not writing them down. So by putting yourself on the camera, you've removed, or you've added, I should say, the other way around, you've added a layer of inhibition. That might be why people, you know, the same people that were kind of nice, I was going to say that way, kind of nice on YouTube, even though they can make rants, can be way, way worse on Facebook and other mediums. Yeah, interesting, isn't it, in a way? And sad in another way, because it just kind of shows that we all have that potential, don't we? We all have that potential of souring, we could say it like that. I don't know. There used to be, I've been trying to think about it, but it doesn't come to me right now. There were some sayings about sour milk or something and related to behavior, but I don't quite remember it right now. Anyway, that doesn't really matter. So tell me, what do you think? Have you had experiences with, you know, with social media that kind of put you off certain people, or made you realize, like, hey, am I becoming something like that? Or I mean, like, I sometimes see things on social media and I really would like to react and say, that's not true, that's wrong, you get the wrong impression, you're putting us all in the same pot. And then I think, like, do I want to jump into that cesspool? And actually, most of the times, much more often than not, I think, no, I don't want to. So anyway, tell me what you think about it. You know, it's a this vlog started from a little scientific article that when I saw it at first, I thought, like, yeah, interesting. And then I keep thinking, sometimes you see things like that and you say, well, is it really all that surprising? No, actually, it isn't. But they were studying which really, like, which neural networks and stuff like that. So it was an interesting paper on its own. Okay, well, spoken long enough. So DC signing off. Hope you have a good Sunday. What's left of it for us? We're already, what are we? Is it? Oh, 3:15. Okay, so still a bit of the afternoon to go, but you know, almost over. Okay, take care. Bye-bye. Signing off. Bye.